Fired FBI Director James Comey says it's possible that Russia has dirt on the president. What does that mean? Joining us now is Democratic Congressman Jim Himes. He's a member of the House Intelligence Committee. Great to have you here, Congressman.
Good morning, Allison.
So it's possible? I mean, that is so broad as to my ear to almost be meaningless. How do you hear that from James Comey?
Well, I don't think anybody knows. I think Jim Comey is being honest. You know, there are suggestions in the Steele memorandum, the Steele dossier. You know, there's possibilities. Interestingly, Allison, there's another layer to this, which is it doesn't really matter if the Russians have something on the president if the president worries that they do. So if the president misbehaved either in Moscow or if he's got some business deal that's a little questionable, it doesn't really matter whether the Russians know that because the president will worry that the Russians know that.
You said on Friday that people will, quote, rot in hell for besmirching the integrity of James Comey and Robert Mueller. Now that you've heard the James Comey interview, is there anything that you think he did wrong?
Well, I was clear about that in the interview where I got a little heated about the character assassination that the Republicans and that the president is doing to two very good men, Mueller and Comey. And I was clear in saying that I actually think it was a mistake for then-Director Comey to come out and talk about the Clinton investigation. He didn't talk about the Trump investigation. And look, there's a credible case to be made that he seriously affected the election, maybe even elected Donald Trump.
So
but that doesn't make him dishonest.
Okay. So, but I mean, critics can go after his judgment.
Absolutely. No, I would agree that his judgment in deciding to break the protocol of the Justice Department in that instance was wrong. There is a long gap between an error of judgment in a very difficult situation. This was tough. I mean, I don't think this was an easy decision for him. And then saying that the man is, if I can quote the president, a liar. I mean, that's just a I don't think anybody believes Jim Comey is a liar. I think a lot of people think he made a misjudgment, but I don't think anybody believes that either Jim Comey or Bob Mueller are anything other than men of integrity.
As a member of the House Intel Committee, as you are, do you think that the firing of James Comey, from everything that you've heard now, does amount to an obstruction of justice from the president?
I think it's three quarters of the way there. I mean, look, the president fired him, and then he told the Russians in the Oval Office that he had had great pressure relieved. And then he told the media that he would have done it anyway in order to take away the pressure of the investigation.
So what part are you still waiting to hear?
Well, you know, I think I'm not a lawyer. I think if the case were strong enough, Mueller will make that case. And look, I mean, it's not just the firing of Comey, right? It's the suggestion that the FBI director Comey should go light on his national security advisor, right? And so, look, Mueller's doing his work. We'll find out what else there is.
So, about Michael Cohen, do you feel that the search of Michael Cohen's home and his office and whatever FBI agent sees, do you feel, as someone who has looked into the evidence, that something is now shifting into a different higher gear?
Well, remember on our side, on the House side, we were not looking into the president's business dealings. That was not in the mandate of our investigation. But it is very clear. Look, if I understand why the president is worried here. From what I understand about Michael Cohen, this guy was Donald Trump's fixer. God only knows what is in those files. And look, we've got a reckoning. Obviously, if there's criminality in those files, that's one thing. This is a little bit reminiscent of the Clinton administration, where we started an investigation in one place, a land deal in Arkansas, and wound up in a very, very different place. And I actually think, look, though I am no fan of this president, I've been a tough critic of it, of the president, unless there's very serious evidence of criminality between Michael Cohen and Donald Trump, the Southern District of New York should be very careful on how they handle any of that information.
Do you think that's a greater legal threat from where you sit to the president?
Well, people who understand these things a good deal better than I do, lawyers and prosecutors, tell me that yes, it is. Because again, Michael Cohen has years of, you know, cleaning up the messes of this president. And God only knows, as I said before, what is in those files. I mean, you know, think back on what Mueller's doing. Mueller is sort of examining whether there is so-called collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians. Collusion is not a crime. Conspiracy is a crime, and conspiracy is a fairly well-defined crime. And we don't know yet, because we don't know what Mueller has, whether he's going to find a crime occurred. My guess is there's probably a lot more fertile ground for the Southern District of New York in Michael Cohen's doings than perhaps Bob Mueller has.
Back to James Comey for a second. Do you think that he should have weighed in on things like the president's looks, his impressions of the president's looks when he first saw him, his impressions of the president's hair, and as well as the unverified, more salacious stuff in the dossier?
Well, that's a good question. I mean, I sort of wonder when he's talking about the president's hair or the president's skin color, whether that's not sort of something that perhaps the book publishers value more than Jim Comey naturally does. Again, I think most people think he's a man of integrity, very focused on the substance, whatever his judgment may have been. On the dossier is a different matter, right? I mean,
the salacious parts of it. He didn't have to answer those questions. He didn't have to include that stuff.
Well, he answered questions he was asked. I didn't hear a lot of discussion of the more salacious aspects of the dossier. And look, the dossier remains exactly what it is, an unverified set of notions produced by a very credible source. So that still remains one of the big question marks in this whole investigation.
All right, Congressman Jim Himes, thank you very much for being here. Always great to see you in
thank
the studio.
You, Elsa.
Chris.
And we're only at the beginning when it comes to Jim Comey's media blitz. Allies of the president are ramping up attacks on his credibility. It seems to be pretty well thought out. So what are we going to see from the president today? Is he going to directly attack Jim Comey? Let's discuss next.